the primary endpoint of the study will be a measure of overeating, and whether we can improve that. But the indication for the drug, should it have two positive studies and get approved, would be for the treatment of Prader-Willi.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Seth Lederman. He is the CEO of Tonix Pharmaceuticals. And Dr. Lederman, nice to see you again. How are you?
I'm well. Thank you for having me on, Steve.
Yeah, big news out from the company talking about moving into a phase two trial with TNX-2900. This around Prader-Willi syndrome. And maybe we could start there and you can give everyone an idea about Prader-Willi syndrome.
Thanks, Steve. Prader-Willi is an orphan condition, and it affects kids early in life with failure to thrive when they're infants. And then later, it is characterized by hyperphagia, which means overeating, which leads to obesity. So Prader-Willi kids have a much shortened lifespan, and it's an unmet need. Although there are two drugs that are FDA approved for it, it's still not completely addressed.
Yeah, so tell us about TNX-2900 and what you're looking at.
Thanks. TNX-2900 is an intranasal oxytocin. Now, intranasal means it's a spray that goes into the nose, and oxytocin is a normal human hormone that is used as a drug to induce labor in the United States, and in Europe, it was used to promote milk in lactating mothers. It used to be approved in the United States for that, but the company abandoned it. So oxytocin is a very interesting normal human peptide, but we and others believe it has a role in treating Prader-Willi. And that's based on two things. One is there's a knockout mouse called the MAGEL2 knockout mouse, MAGEL2. And Prader-Willi has good effects in reversing some of the effects of Prader-Willi in that model. And also, there's a study where intranasal oxytocin has had beneficial effects in infants. Our study, though, will be treating children and adolescents, looking to see the effect of intranasal oxytocin in Prader-Willi.
Yeah, so the phase two trial, as you mentioned, basically aged 8 to 17 and a half. Is that accurate? So, and that's not
Exactly.
going to start till next year, right?
Correct. Correct.
Yeah. Tell us a little bit about what kind of outcome you'll be looking at. Like, what are sort of the parameters that you would look at in this particular study? Is it beginning with safety or some other things? What is happening?
Well, we'll be looking at safety and efficacy, and the way that Prader-Willi expresses its problems in children this age, children and adolescents, is by overeating. So the primary endpoint of the study will be a measure of overeating, and whether we can improve that. But the indication for the drug, should it have two positive studies and get approved, would be for the treatment of Prader-Willi.
Well, we'll be interested to see how this all rolls out in 2026, Dr. Lederman. Thank you so much. Really appreciate the update, and we'll talk soon, okay?
Thank you very much for your interest.
All right, Dr. Seth Lederman, the CEO of Tonix Pharmaceuticals.